just some few figures, and also to remind you that there's a question from this slide in the spinal canal, that which is nothing but the subarachnoid space around the spinal cord, as well as the central canal, if at all it exists. And the normal CSF pressure is around 8 to 15. The upper limit is sometimes around 20. And this is important when you measure the CSF pressure or when you maintain the height of the external ventricular drain in your ICUs. The rate of production of CSF is approximately 500 ml per day. And this 500 ml keeps circulating in this particular form. This is a very schematic diagram again, showing the lateral ventricles over here. From the lateral ventricles through a small corridor called the foramen of Monroe, it reaches another box called the third ventricle. From the third ventricle to the fourth ventricle through the aqueduct, and the fourth ventricle, there are some outlets through which it reaches the spinal canal as well as the subarachnoid space. So this is how it is formed inside the brain. This is a very schematic diagram again to show you how exactly it circulates. There is a heart, there are blood vessels arising from the heart. Blood vessels supply the brain, and from the brain there is again venous return back to the heart. If we take the brain and then see the blood vessels which go to the choroid plexus, which I told are the blood vessels inside the ventricles, especially the lateral ventricles, most of the CSF is formed in these lateral ventricles. All of you must be familiar with these pictures, you must have seen some scans, but let us correlate this scan with this cadaveric specimen. This is a sequence of MRI on which it is very easy to make out CSF because it is white in color. And if you see, there are areas where there is more whiteness, those are the ventricles. And there are areas around the, there are sulci within the gyri of the brain. That is also white in color. That is the subarachnoid space of the brain wherein the CSF is located. And these subarachnoid spaces are dilated in some areas. If you see this area, it is not a ventricle, but it is a dilated subarachnoid space. It's called a cistern. So CSF is located in the ventricles, cisterns, and the subarachnoid spaces. This is the whole brain and the spinal MRI over here. The circulation of CSF around the brain as well as through the subarachnoid space of the spinal canal. So whatever you see white around the spinal cord is also CSF. So CSF is produced somewhere over here, mainly the lateral ventricles, circulates around the spinal cord, and finally, where is it absorbed? Let's see that. All of us know that there are three layers around the spinal, around the meninges, around the brain and spinal cord. That is from outer to inside, the dura mater, the arachnoid, and the pia mater. And this is a section through the superior surface of the head, somewhere like this. That's called the coronal section.